opportunity, but then will be given a new mask for when they return to their seats. We thank you for your cooperation with this requirement.
Thank you. Please rise for the playing of O Canada on the saxophone by Eagle Butte High School graduating student Jessica Vandor.
Thank you. Please be seated. Welcome again to the Eagle Butte High School's graduation ceremonies for the class of 2021. I'm Sheldon Weenan, school counselor and teacher at Eagle Butte High School. I'm excited that we're able to have an indoor graduation and be able to celebrate the class of 2021. Aren't they gorgeous behind those masks? It has been my privilege to be a counselor of these students for the past 3 years. I've also had the pleasure of teaching many of them in my physical education classes and coaching them in badminton. I've enjoyed the many conversations and discussions with these students as they've progressed from grade 10 to grade 12. I have found this group of students to be very personable and enthusiastic.
My name is Heather Laternis, and I too am a counselor and teacher. I had the pleasure of teaching many of these graduates in their grade 10 year at Eagle Butte. In the school counselor role, Mr. Weenan and I have enjoyed discussing these students' courses, life challenges, and future plans. There can be many challenges that come with high school when there isn't a global pandemic. We've been impressed with the way that this group has overcome the many obstacles thrown their way. This experience will help to build resilience, a quality that will serve them well in the future. Mr. Weenan and I will be the MCs for this event. The theme chosen by the class of 2021 is On My Way. Eagle Butte High School acknowledges that we are situated on Treaty 7 and Treaty 4 territory, traditional lands of the Siksika, Kainai, Piikani, Stoney Nakoda, and Tsuut'ina, as well as the Cree, Sioux, and Saudu bands of the Ojibwe peoples. We also honor and acknowledge that we are on the homelands of the Métis Nation within Region 3. We acknowledge the many First Nations, Métis, and Inuit people whose footsteps have marked these lands for generations. We are grateful for the traditional knowledge keepers and elders who are still with us today and those who have gone before us. Our recognition of this land is an act of reconciliation and an expression of our gratitude to those whose territory we reside on or are visiting.
This year, Mr. Ricci will be videoing the entire formal ceremonies, and a live stream is currently available on the Eagle Butte High School Facebook page. A link will also be made available on this site for later viewing on YouTube. We would also like to inform parents that Life Touch Photography will be taking a graduate principal picture of each grad as they receive their grad portfolio from Mr. Heinrichs. These pictures will be available for purchase on the LifeTouch website. At this time, we would like to introduce our platform guests, Mr. Mark Heinrichs, principal of Eagle Butte High School, Mr. John Baird, vice principal, and Mrs. Rochelle Howes, vice principal.
Mr. Cal Cook is the Assistant Superintendent of the Prairie Rose Public School Division. We will now have greetings from Mr. Cook by video on behalf of Prairie Rose Public School Division.
Good afternoon, parents, Eagle Butte High School staff, and the graduating class of 2021. What a great day this is for you. You've officially completed 12 years of schooling, and now you get to celebrate your formal graduation ceremonies. We all know the effects of this new reality. 2 years ago, Good afternoon. Good afternoon, parents, Eagle Butte High School. Good afternoon, parents, Eagle Butte High School staff, and the graduating class of 2021. What a great day this is for you. You've officially completed 12 years of schooling, and now you get to celebrate your formal graduation ceremonies. We all know the effects of this new reality. 2 years ago, a conversation about lockdowns, quarantining, online learning, and hoping for an in-person celebration was not part of your reality. My mother always told me to try to see the positive in people, or in this case, our circumstances. If there's anything positive affiliated to you from this pandemic, I would say that you have learned to take true ownership of your learning. You've developed independence.
Difficulty. And so we're going to skip to a live portion of our program, and we're going to come back to Mr. Cook in a few minutes.
All right, we're going to have Mr. Heinrichs come up. Mr. Heinrichs is the principal of Eagle Butte High School and is currently completing his 16th year of administration. Mr. Heinrichs teaches math 30-1, holds the door open at the end of the day for each student as they exit through the school, and is often seen filling vending machines and helping out with the school's recycling program. He says the most rewarding part of his job is talking and interacting with students during the school day. Now that the pandemic is coming to an end, we hope that he doesn't develop carpal tunnel syndrome from spraying all that disinfectant into hundreds of hands over the past school year. Please welcome Mr. Heinrichs.
Good afternoon, everybody. I used to think Walmart greeter when I was done with education would be kind of the place to go, but after this year, now I've had my fill of greeting at the doorway with spray anyways. Do a little bit of an audience check here just to gain a sense of the mood today. So as I pondered what to write, I decided to go for a run with my Chromebook in hand to be able to quickly write down any ideas that came to mind. I was hoping this would jog my memory.
And get Eagle Butte High School staff. Graduating class.
Not bad. Okay. I was going to attempt to write this speech with a pencil. You know, old school. But it very quickly broke, so my attempt was pointless. I know we should have a drum after that. Okay, not so bad. Got the students behind me, so that's good. They'll have my back as I go. Welcome, parents, family members, friends, but most importantly, members of the graduating class of 2021. As principal of Eagle Butte, let me say that I am here today representing all of the staff at Eagle Butte High School. There was a definite feeling of disappointment again this year when I had to inform the staff that due to COVID-19 restrictions, we would only be able to send a skeleton crew to this special event. I'm sure that everyone in this audience has had similar sentiments. With that being said, All of our staff truly do send their best for each of you grads, and they have nothing but admiration and congratulations for getting to this point. You've definitely earned this moment. A similar sentiment is being sent from our trustee, Kathy Hogg, who was unable to attend this event this year as well. Let's recap how we started this year. You might remember this, grads. And sanitize, physical distance, mask, mask, mask. And sanitize, physical distance, mask, mask, mask. What a long time it's been since that video message was sent out last fall. How much you have all endured, embraced, and overcome. It truly is amazing what you have experienced and learned as we hopefully are coming to an end of this COVID experience. The key to any of life's experiences is to endure well, but most importantly, to then gain something from the experiences that we have all been a part of. It reminds me of a quick story. I'm going to take a moment to tell it. Everyone knows that turkeys can't really fly, but the paradigm was recently broken by an enterprising eagle in the United States of America. He believed in nurture versus nature, that all creatures could learn and overcome the limitations of their genetics. This eagle set up a flying school for turkeys, advertising soar like an eagle on turkey channels and social media. The response was tremendous. Turkeys from everywhere wanted to soar. After registering the first 100 applicants, the eagle began with a plethora of courses. The turkeys spent the first 4 weeks in classrooms learning the essentials of aerodynamics and gliding. The next 4 weeks concentrated on training. The turkeys first learned to glide off of chairs and then stools. Soon they were flying 20 to 30 feet at a time. By the end of the 8th week, the miraculous happened and the turkeys were soaring in the skies just like the eagles. It was an incredible sight. A graduation ceremony was set up. Turkey families came from all over to attend. Fathers boasted to their friends and mothers wept with pride. The diplomas were given and then the turkeys all walked home. What a sad finish to a glorious training. I'm hoping with all that you've been a part of, grads, over the last 15 months, with all that you've learned over 13 years of school, that you are not turkeys and would rather soar like eagles from the knowledge you've gained. Use what you've been taught and have experienced, good and difficult, to make the most of the journey that lies ahead. Finally, let me conclude with two traditions just to keep my string alive. First of all, today is Friday, and for some of these graduating students, on Fridays, when I remember, it is things that make you go, hmm. I always tell those that I teach, I don't invent these, I just read them. Some are obvious, others maybe not so obvious. The first one for today, the best apple to eat, the one with the worm in it, no pesticides. Number two, the most dangerous animal in Ireland, the bumblebee. And lastly, my favorite one for today, the three things that pregnant women dream of the most in their first 3 months of pregnancy. I just read them. First one is frogs, next one is worms, and then lastly, potted plants. Finally, what has become my traditional salutation at Eagle Butte graduations, and yes, for some of the parents, I am old enough now that you might remember this from the past, but is very fitting for this milestone event. My traditional conclusion is this, from the words of the famous philosopher Confucius, grads, wherever you go, go with all your heart. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2021.
High school staff.
Okay, so we're going to try take two of Mr. Cook, the Assistant Superintendent of Prairie Rose Public School Division.
Good afternoon, parents, Eagle Butte High School staff, and the graduating class of 2021. What a great day this is for you. You've officially completed 12 years of schooling, and now you get to celebrate your formal graduation ceremonies. We all know the effects of this new reality. 2 years ago, a conversation about lockdowns, quarantining, online learning, and hoping for an in-person celebration was not part of your reality. My mother always told me to try to see the positive in people, or in this case, our circumstances. If there's anything positive affiliated to you, from this pandemic, I would say that you have learned to take true ownership of your learning. You've developed independence and experienced what resiliency truly means. Embrace these qualities as they will serve you well. I wish you all the best with your future plans and endeavors. And more importantly, I wish you good health and a strong mind. On behalf of Mr. Clark, Superintendent, Reagan Weeks, Deputy Superintendent, and myself at Prairie Rose Public Central Office, congratulations on this important milestone. We are very proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Cook. This afternoon, we will have several musical performances. Our first performance is For Good from the musical Wicked. Our graduates have spent a great deal of time with each other, with their families, and with our school staff. They have been changed by those around them and have influenced one another in positive ways. Here are Julianne Jans and Madeline Fisher.
Thank you.
Thank you, students, for that excellent performance. If you could all stand for those that participated in that number. Now for the moment to which the graduates have been waiting for. 13 years of education have culminated today as our grade 12s receive recognition of completing Alberta graduation requirements. Before we begin the presentation of the diplomas, we'd like to explain the procedure that will take place. Hopefully this will assist parents and families in taking pictures. Graduates will approach the platform from your left and move to the right as they cross the stage.
First, Mr. Heinrichs will present the student with their graduation portfolio, a gold cord for attaining an average of 80% or higher throughout all 3 years of high school, and a teal cord for successfully earning 135 credits or more. Next, Mr. Baird or Mrs. Howes will turn each grad's tassel, indicating that each student has graduated. The grads will then make their way back to their row. Will the first row of graduates please rise? Merrick Rodney Andrews, graduating with honors. J.C. Jean Auger, graduating with honors. Karis Alexandra Barnes. Luke Norman Bauer. Emily Angeline Becker, graduating with honors and due diligence. Haley Rebecca Rose Bender. Aaron William Benz. Maya Angel Berg. Nicholas Lyle Bojackley, graduating with due diligence. Russell Allen Douglas Bowie. Sydney Grace Carlson. Jackson Clayton Alvin Chiroka, graduating with due diligence. Sydney Allison Krush. Taryn Lynn Cole. Dayden Vern Theoden Collier. Jayla May Crooks. Megan Judith Curran, graduating with honors and due diligence. Lexi Morgan Currents. Justin Michael Daw. Caden Brant Devins. Josie Lynn Dreffs, graduating with honors and due diligence. Mackenzie Rain Dukeshire. Caden Darren Dumanowski, graduating with due diligence. Olivia Elaine Durkee. Emmett Lewis Eckstein. Trip Lyle Ellis, graduating with due diligence. Wesley Allen Ewart, graduating with honors. Kinley Christine Grace Fasselt, graduating with honors. Madeline Adrienne Fisher, graduating with honors and due diligence. Charlie Moran Foster, graduating with honors. Eric Franca Turner. Tanner Lane Gates. Brianna Rose Gowell, graduating with honors and due diligence. Brittany Ann Gowell. Emily Taylor George. Jude Isaac Colm Goddard. Tyrese Goring, graduating with honors. Tanner Austin Gold, graduating with honors. Caden Charles George Grant. Justin Michael Greenstein. Levi Ryan Hart. Annette de la Caridad Echevarria Linares, graduating with honors. Harrison Anthony Heinrichs. Georgia Melanie Heisler, graduating with due diligence. Sheridan Avery Herman, graduating with honors and due diligence. Emma Grace Herselman. Will Durant Hockley, graduating with honors. Angus Fraser Robert Horsberg. Haley Nicole Huffadine, graduating with honors. Jessica Marie Hunt. Jameson Jeffrey Mark Igarta, graduating with due diligence. Natasha Christine Jagger, graduating with honors and due diligence. Damon Adam Jarris. Julianne Jans, graduating with honors and due diligence. Amen. Riley Kirkhoff. Kiana Blaze Klanknecht, graduating with honors. Lincoln Palmer Leo Koborinski. Aiden Christopher Robert Cornelson. Carter Nicholas Lawson. Emily Rose Lair. McKenna Jade Lair, graduating with due diligence. Adeline Ruth Joyce Liveso, graduating with honors and due diligence. Raylene Elizabeth Lundquist, graduating with due diligence. Owen Marshall Lutz.
Chase Simon Paul Madsen. Kiana Emma Margetz. Megan Tyler Marr. Dawson Charles George Martin. Kai Addison Riley Martin. Kiera Nikita Paige Martin. Allison Elizabeth Mason. Alyssa Marie McCasey, graduating with honors. Krista May McKnight, graduating with due diligence. Thomas Edward Melton. Chevelle Cassandra Miller. Ty James Moore. Austin Maine Munch, graduating with due diligence. Alexis Virginia Murray. Colton Darcy Neal. Taya Avery Joy Nelligan. Jarrett Troy Nicholson, graduating with honors. Sid Norquay. Tanner Chance Nyland. Claire Teresa O'Connell, graduating with honors and due diligence. Lindsay Diane O'Connell, graduating with honors and due diligence. Ashlyn Ann Oliver. Tobias Olivier. Bailey Amber Pearson, graduating with due diligence. Cheyenne Debbie Peters, graduating with honors. Alexandra Layla Plamondon, graduating with honors. Callan Tyler Prasovsky. Jody J. Rath, graduating with due diligence. Caden Reed Rath, graduating with honors and due diligence. Shelby Ray Riling, graduating with due diligence. Clayton Jack Ranke, graduating with due diligence. Justina Caroline Ranke, graduating with honors and due diligence. Russell Frederick Ranke, graduating with due diligence. Jackson Dane Rice, graduating with honors and due diligence. Chantel Cassie Richard, graduating with honors. Venus Rain Rivers, graduating with honors. McKenna Hope Rondo. Marley Dawn Rael Rose. Summer Marie Rose. Darren Lane Salzel. Naomi June Schick, graduating with honors and due diligence. Brianna Jade Schlosser, graduating with honors and due diligence. Brooke Renee Schwartz. Sierra Rose Sedlecki, graduating with honors and due diligence. Cassidy Aaron Simmons, graduating with honors. Brennan John Sleeking. Julia Kaylin Squire, graduating with honors and due diligence. Aiden Owen Stewartson. Alexis K. Lynn Streifel. McKenna Renee Teets, graduating with due diligence. Annika Lee Treichel, graduating with honors. Mason Keir Trihorn, graduating with honors. Quentin Pierce Unreiner. Jessica Elise Van Dor. Kyler Derek Van Dorp. Mackenzie Ann Verge. Caden Richard Volman. Caitlin Nicole Voss, graduating with due diligence. Raquel Leslie Lynn Wallbauer, graduating with honors and due diligence. Caitlin Dawn Watson, graduating with due diligence. Lacey Quinn Wise. Jackson Booker Wenham, graduating with honors and due diligence. Hannah Marie White, graduating with honors. Janae Elizabeth Whitfield. Sydney Ann Wood, graduating with honors. There they are, the graduating class of 2021. Our next performance is Dane Rice with the song "You Are Loved" by Josh Groban. As our graduates move forward, we hope this song reminds them that there are many people in their lives that love them.
To be loved.
Dane, will you stand up? Thank you. Thank you, Dane, for that wonderful song and message. We would now like to invite Georgia Heisler and Raylene Lundquist to do the parent tribute. Following their tribute, there will be a reply from Graham Heisler and Carrie Lundquist. We invite all of them to come to the stage now.
Good afternoon, fellow grads, teachers, family, friends, and most importantly, parents and guardians. For the past 18 years, it has been all about us kids.
It is high time we take a moment to recognize the actual reason we are all here today. This moment is for the parents and all that they do.
There are countless duties and responsibilities that come with being a parent, which is a job that lasts a lifetime. The life lessons are endless. And then there are those typical parent reminders that you repeat over and over again. We try and block them out, but we also know that the words need to be taken to heart.
You have been there for all the firsts. First steps, first words, first eye rolls, first attitude, and first late curfews.
They provide endless I love yous, be safe, and drive safe. I can only imagine how our parents feel watching us drive away each time. I don't know how many of you have been in our parking lot, but it can be a gone show some days. While some drivers are pretty good, others may need a few more lessons in shoulder checking. I know, Dad, I still have the dent in my bumper that needs to be fixed. Thank you for teaching us how to drive and being there for those fender benders that happen, both on the road and in real life.
Our parents open doors to new opportunities and encourage us to have fun and put ourselves out there, followed by a, but don't do anything I wouldn't do. Right, Mom and Dad?
From our many backgrounds, we have been taught to work towards something you want, that good things come to people who wait, and to be nice to other kids, which usually means do no harm, but also take no bull. You have taught us to stand up for ourselves and also being considerate of others.
The endless nights of homework at the kitchen table, last minute purchases for projects, back-to-school shopping trips, and hours in cars going from sports or 4-H, or even picking us up from late nights at our friend's house. You were always a safe ride home.
To be honest, these last 12 years of school have been more of a team sport than an individual one. So guess what, Mom and Dad? We graduated.
Standing here thinking about our peers and who they are as people really shines a light on the remarkable parenting that has shaped them.
Eagle Butte has many students that come from different feeder schools that all integrate together from a variety of communities. We have the Hicks from Seven Persons, the Cliffside Kids, the Irvinites, and it's hard to forget about the massive number of students we get from Ralston and Schuller.
Just like our backgrounds, all of our families are different in many ways, but we can celebrate what we all share. The love and support that has helped us reach this chapter in our lives.
COVID provided many changes in our lives. We went from attending public school to experiencing at-home learning. It provided more time to spend with our families, which can be taken as bonding or overwhelming, but we all got through it together.
Even with the not working cameras and our spotty Wi-Fi connections that made us late to class. There is a quote by an anonymous writer that says, be who you needed when you were young. Throughout every moment of our lives, most, if not all of us, needed you, parents. And fear not, when we are all moved out, we still will.
You were the chauffeur, the bank, the alarm clock, and the discipliner who taught us right from wrong. You will always be the ones to guide and support us, even if we are miles away. You will always be the ones that we need and the examples that we want to be.
So can the graduates please join us in a huge round of applause
to say thank you to our parents and all that they do.
All right. Good afternoon, everybody. Hang on, I want to do things a little different here. Come on, Carrie, let's do a quick Snapchat. We learn from the best. All right, you ready? Come on. We need some more duck in there. Duck lips. All right, ready now. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, teachers, and most importantly, graduates of 2021. My name is Graham Heisler, and I'm honored to stand up here to give a toast to the grads of 2021. As 30 years ago, almost to the day, I was in your guys' shoes.
Welcome, everyone. My name is Carrie Lundquist, although I'm much younger than you, Graham. It has been a few years since my graduation also. I'll be the co-pilot for the tribute to the grads of 2021. Graham, many of these graduates were born 18 years ago in the year 2003. What do you remember from that year?
November 2003 was a very special time for me. It was the first ever Heritage Hockey Classic. First ever, ever. This was the outdoor NHL hockey game with 60,000 plus fans in the stands. And instead of enjoying the game, my bride decided to have a baby during the game, which was just the start of a 48-hour ordeal. Another memory I remember was SARS. Who knew 18 years later we'd have another pandemic? And basically turn us into a tailspin by shutting down the world.
How about mad cow disease? This too hindered the livelihood of many parents in this room as farmers and ranchers. But 2003 wasn't all bad. Gas was 66 cents a liter. The movie Finding Nemo was released. And thank goodness we were blessed with the birth of these graduates to leave us happy memories from that year. The graduates of 2021 have formed some everlasting friendships and memories. Some of these friends may come and go, but along the way, you all have impacted your life and made you learn something about yourself. I feel that this idea of belonging and socializing started at a very young age. Starting off at school age, we as parents would encourage play dates.
Yes, Carrie. And as they got older, we discouraged them. Eagle Butte High School is a mixing bowl for students. They get students from all over, like Irvin. Walsh! I can't hear you.
Dunmore and Medicine Hat.
How about Schuler?
Bowl and Ralston?
I think they even get some from Redcliffe. There are many of these students I have watched grow up over the years from ECS to grade 12. For instance, I had to attend the Irvin ECS barbecue 13 years ago. I had to go find out who the kissing bandit was. From watching numerous school sports, it was fantastic to see how students evolved. From learning to bump a volleyball, dribble a basketball, smash a birdie, to some of them are even flying on their own. It's kind of scary. I don't know if I'd trust them on the road, not to mention the air.
That's right, Graham. From starting things on fire in Mr. Resch's science class to graduating and being ready to navigate the world on their own. Seeing your grad coveralls periodically throughout the year is a great indication that you are ready for the workforce. While you may all look like mechanics, we know that no matter where your life leads you or whatever you choose to do, us as parents are here to support you as you find and capture your dreams. As parents, we remember our children losing their first tooth, riding their first bike, their first days of school.
First accident? Who knew dads could turn into auto body mechanics?
Listening to stories of the school parking lot, I think we need to go back to the bikes with training wheels. As parents, you kids may think we repeat ourselves over and over when we say things like drive safe.
Yep, clean your room.
Do your laundry.
Watch for deer.
Wash your hands.
2020 and 2021 has been some years that will go down in history. The likes of COVID-19 seem to drag on, similar to the construction at the school. Don't be defined by COVID. Let the resilience define you.
But as you move on to become more independent, we hope you remember these little tidbits. You are about to begin a new chapter in your lives. It may take some of you to college or university, traveling, or right into the workforce. Remember, a new chapter for you is also a new chapter for us parents. No matter what your future holds or what path you choose, know we will be here to support you. Your future does not lay in front of you, it lies deep inside you. Life is not about finding yourself, it's about creating yourself. When life becomes a roller coaster, climb into the front seat, throw your arms in the air, and enjoy the ride. Rise by lifting others. When life gets crazy, do something normal. And if life gets too normal, do something crazy. Always be nice. Life is about how you handle plan B. Practice the art of listening. Play with the wild abandon, no matter how old you get. Find the joy in all choices you make. Remember, in the end, people always win. Never forget, we will love you forever, for always, no matter what.
Graduating high school is a huge accomplishment. This is a stepping stone to your future. Enjoy these moments, live for today, learn from the past, and focus on the future. Spread your wings, reach for the clouds, and follow your dreams and take them to new heights. As you gather in the next couple of days with your friends, I want you all to reflect, reminisce on your successes and memories. In a blink of an eye, you'll end up here telling stories and fighting your kids for leftovers in the fridge. On behalf of the parents of the graduates of 2021, as Alan Jackson sang in 2003, it's 5 o'clock somewhere. Congratulations. Toast to the graduates of 2021. We love you. Please stand and applaud to the graduates of Eagle Butte High School 2021.
Thank you, Georgia and Raylene, and Graham and Carrie for those special words. The valedictorian is chosen for highest academic achievement in his or her class. This year's valedictorian says that she enjoys all of her classes, especially math, physics, and Flight Academy. This fall, Lindsay will be attending the University of Calgary, where she will be studying engineering. While at Eagle Butte, she played volleyball, basketball, badminton, and took part in track and field and cross-country running. Lindsay was also involved in music at Eagle Butte. Please welcome the valedictorian for the class of 2021, Miss Lindsay O'Connell.
Hello, my name is Lindsay O'Connell, and I'm honored to be the valedictorian of Eagle Butte High School's graduating class of 2021. Can you believe we are all here together in one room to celebrate this milestone in our lives? I've thought a lot about other 2021 graduating classes across the province and how they are celebrating their graduation. We are so fortunate to be able to celebrate ours together in one facility. While it wasn't the senior year we had all imagined, we were able to make the most of it. Volleyball athletes were able to play some matches against local schools. The softball team has been playing recently. Track and field had a virtual track meet. Badminton and basketball teams practiced. Student Council organized fundraisers for local organizations, and our music class was able to perform and record musical performances for grad. One constant we had when in school was always seeing Mr. Heinrichs there to hold the door open for us before and after school. There are so many people to thank for helping us through our journey. Our teachers, family, coaches, and friends have provided us with guidance and inspiration for the past 13 years of school. First, I want to thank the teachers and staff for continuously developing us from kindergarten through our senior year. It was interesting that what I learned in kindergarten regarding sharing and cooperation applied to how we managed to fit 400 cars into a 380-stall parking lot. Our teachers have shown tremendous perseverance over the past 18 months with the changes from classroom to online to classroom to online to classroom teaching. Throw in a few isolations around the school, and our teachers have basically taught in every format possible. Thank you for keeping us engaged in our learning, ensuring our personal safety at school, and adjusting to all the challenges that were encountered. Collectively, across our school years, teachers have taught us how to think for ourselves, ask questions of others, have an open mind, and most importantly, to form connections with others. Additionally, on behalf of the Academy students, I want to say thank you to the divisional staff that had the vision to develop our amazing academies that are an important part of our school. These include the Hockey and Flight Academy. These opportunities have allowed us to meet so many new people from across Western Canada and also lift ourselves to new heights as we pursue our passions. For this, I am personally grateful. As for all of our parents, I don't even know where to start. You mean the world to us. In our home lives, you have encouraged us, challenged us, and developed us to contribute to our community in a meaningful way. In our academic pursuits, you've helped open our eyes to dream about what is possible and how we can achieve it. I would like to express my thanks to the parents who have put in a lot of effort to help provide us with a memorable graduating experience. We all greatly appreciate the effort, time, and investments you have made to our growth and development. I believe the best way to show our gratitude to our parents is by making the most of the opportunities we have been given. Thank you, parents. To my classmates, we made it. We are the first graduating class to have completed their entire senior year during a global pandemic. The entirety of the COVID experience has built resilience and adaptability that will serve us well in the future. Eagle Butte has connected us all together from many schools, towns, and cities from across Western Canada. As we have shared our time together at Eagle Butte, many strong bonds have been formed that will remain as we move on to the next chapters of our lives. Of the 137 graduates in our class, there are countless individual dreams and goals. I wish for all of my classmates the opportunity to put their knowledge and experience to use when it comes to chasing their dreams. We need to stay committed to our decisions, but be flexible in our approach. With this in mind, I believe that we have many of the tools that we will need to successfully navigate and overcome setbacks. I'm very excited to start a new chapter in my journey. My hope is that wherever your path leads, you can look forward to these two things with certainty: a new normal and the beginning of new experiences and connections with others. Thank you.
Thank you, Lindsay, for speaking on behalf of the graduates. Over the last few weeks, I've enjoyed hearing our grade 12s reminisce about their school memories, often with much laughter. Our final performance of the afternoon is from Justina and Russell Ranke. They will perform How They Remember You by Rascal Flatts. This song invites us all to consider how we will be remembered.
Sprayed my name on water tower, carved in it an old cottonwood tree. Signed a bunch of high school yearbooks so they wouldn't forget about me. It wasn't until I saw my daddy's name in stone I knew. It ain't a question of if they will, it's how they remember you. Did you stand or did you fall? Build a bridge or build a wall? Hide your love or give it all? What did you do? What did you do? Did you make them laugh or make them cry? Did you quit or did you try? Live your dreams or let them die? What did you choose? What did you choose? When it all comes down, it ain't if, it's how they remember you. When you're down to your last dollar, give or will you take? When the stiff wind blows the hardest, will you bend or will you break? You're gonna leave a legacy no matter what you do. It ain't a question of if they will, it's how they remember you. Did you stand or did you fall? Build a bridge or build a wall? Hide your love or give it?
Thank you, Justine and Russell, for sharing your talents with us. Please stand. At this time, we would also like to give special thanks to Mrs. Morrison and Mr. Ricci for all their hard work and effort in supporting our students in these amazing musical presentations. I'd like to call upon Mr. Baird to give the closing remarks.
Good afternoon. While this may have been the most interesting grad year we've had, with masks, restrictions, quarantines, sanitizer, disinfectant, at-home learning, and the pandemic, we're so very glad we finally get the opportunity to celebrate this important milestone in these young ladies' and gentlemen's lives. This was most definitely a grad year like no other. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate all of our graduating class. Well done, grads of 2021. We are proud of each and every one of you. Please join me in congratulating the graduates one last time. Before we conclude these proceedings, it is important that we acknowledge and thank everyone for their work in planning and organizing the events of today. A special thank you goes out to the following individuals that have put considerable time and effort into the celebrations. Mr. Weenan and Mrs. Laternis for coordinating today's formal ceremony, Mrs. Craven, Ms. Kyle, Ms. Johnston, and their parent team for decorating, Mrs. McGarry and Mrs. Kelly for the organization of caps, gowns, and programs, Mr. Ricci for the media and the grad video, Mr. Dola for pictures, Mrs. Morrison and the students who have provided the music, Mrs. Kraus and her team for the formal day activities and the fun awards, along with Adeline Lifeso for the baby pictures PowerPoint, Mrs. Elgie for finances, Ms. Bonagowski, Ms. McCubbin, Ms. Johnston, and Mrs. Craven, as well as Mrs. Morrison for acting as ushers and taking tickets today, and all other staff and parents that have lent a hand. Please give a round of applause for them all. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen in the audience, for sharing the celebration with us today. Once I introduce our graduating class, our grads may choose to toss their caps in celebration. The caps may be retrieved by the graduates after the recessional to the back of the Cypress Center. We ask all graduates to please keep your masks on as you recess to the back and turn in your gowns. You may then come back up to the stage to retrieve your caps while you're masked. As our audience exits at the end of today, please do so with your masks on. This time, we would ask all guests in the audience to please remain in your chairs until all graduates recess to the back of the Cypress Center. Now the moment we've all been waiting for. Graduates, would you please rise? Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to present to you the Eagle Butte High School graduating class of 2021.
Well, pick me up with golden hand. Hombre, say, hombre, tell you to run.
All the way, all the way.
I'm over to see, I'm over to see. Well, I would like to hold my little hand. How we will run, how we will cry.
reach out my hand, only say, only tell you to run.
All the way, all the way.
Nobody say, nobody on.
Red sky fading, let's do this right. What you're drinking's what I'm drinking, who's got a light? We about to burn up this 9 to 5 from dusk till dawn. Man, it's on. Blue jean babies, 501s. Music's playing, yeah, we're swaying. Turn this one up. These stars.